Hello guys, in this video we will see how to draw an ER diagram for given case study. As we know that when we are developing any software application, UML diagrams we are going to design. In same way, whenever we are going to design any kind of database applications, we have to draw the ER diagrams. The ER diagrams will be converted later on into relational schemas. And relational schemas are implemented in the forms of your database and tables. Here we have one case study for school management system, and we are going to draw a ER diagram for this. Some information is given related to this case study for school management system. Based on this, we will see how to draw the ER diagram. Now let us read what is the given information. We have been asked to implement database for school management system. This information consists of maintaining the student information like name, address, date of birth, roll number, department, and so on. So this five things we have to store in the student: name, address, date of birth, roll number, and department. Next, details about the school is to be stored, which includes school name and location. Although it is unlikely that there would be two schools at the same place with same name, but our school management system will like to accommodate this possibility. It means that we should take one more attribute named as ID, which is going to identify a school uniquely. So for school, we can consider school name, school ID, and the location of school. Next, given information is faculty members works in the school. They teaches to the students. Faculty member normally teaches multiple students at a time. Also, he can teach multiple courses to the students. So this information has been given for regarding school management system, and we have to draw a ER diagram. ER diagram is basically entity relationship diagram. So these are the steps. These steps are used to draw a ER diagrams. First step is identify the entities, we can say entity sets also, and their attributes. Second step is draw entities. Whatever entities we have identified here, we have to draw all those entities. Identify relationships, this is my step number 3. Draw relationship, that is my step number 4. And last step is identify the mapping cardinalities and represent them. So we will perform all those 5 steps and we will draw the ER diagram. Now step number 1. The step number 1 is identify entities, sets, and their attributes. So in this given information, here I have to record information of student. So student can be entity. This can be their attributes: name, address, date of birth, roll number, and department. So first entity is my student, and the attributes are name, address, date of birth, roll, and department. Second entity, I am having school. In school, we have to store school name, location, and my school should be identified uniquely. That's why I am taking one more attribute named as ID, and this is the school ID. So for school entity, we have name, school name, location, and SID. Next attribute I am having, entity I am having as a faculty. For faculty entity, I can take these attributes: faculty name, faculty address, faculty date of joining, faculty ID. Although it is not given here, but we can take as per our convenience. And last entity I am going to consider here, it's a courses. Faculty can teaches multiple courses to the students. So courses can be courses, it means the subjects. So course, I will take course ID, title of the course, and credits. So we have 4 entities, and these are the attributes of respective entities. So this is my step number 1, identify entity sets and their attributes. Now step number 2 is draw entities. Now here I am having 4 entities. I am going to draw only the first entity is student. So this rectangle is going to represent student entity. Rectangle is symbol for entity. Ellipse is symbol for attributes. So for the student entity, we have 5 attributes: role, name, address, date of birth, and department. Out of these, role number can be chosen as a primary key because it's a unique. Department cannot be unique. Date of birth, address, and name cannot be unique. That's why this is a primary key, and which is underlined, which is going to show it's a primary key. So this is my step number 2. I don't have to draw only this student entity, but you can draw the same thing for school also. You have to draw the same thing for faculty also, and you have to do the same thing for course also. So you will have the 4 entities along with their attributes. Now next step is identify the relationships between entities. I have these 4 entities. Now I'll try to identify the relations between first entity is student and second is school. So what will be the relation between student and school? So we can simply write student studies in a school. So studies can be a relation. Faculty and school is the next entity. So faculty works in the school. So that is works in is my relation. Faculty and course. Faculty teaches the course. Faculty is the entity, course is the entity, and teaches is going to become a relation. And relations are represented in ER diagram as a diamond. Next entities are student and course. So student takes the courses. So text is going to become a relation. So I have these 4 relations here. These 4 relations are in between your entities. Now next step to draw the ER diagram is draw the relationships. So we will draw these 4 entities. The first entity is student, next is school, next is faculty, next is course. The student entity we have represented with the left rectangle, school entity represented with the left rectangle, faculty rectangle, course rectangle. I haven't drawn any kind of attributes here, but you have to draw the attributes also. For example, for student we are having these 5 attributes. So here for student you have to draw the 5 attributes. For school you are having 3 attributes. So here for school you are having 3 attributes. For faculty you are having 4 attributes. So these 4 attributes will come to this faculty. And for course you are having 3 attributes. So for course you will have the 3 attributes. Now when I am going to draw the relation between student and school, what is the relation? Studies in. So we have drawn a studies in relation, which is in between faculty and school. Faculty and school, the relation is works in. So faculty works in school. So works in will be the relation. Similarly, faculty and course, in between faculty and course, the relation will be teaches. Faculty teaches the course. And student takes the courses. So text is going to become a relation. So this is the relations. Now my last step is to draw the mapping cardinalities and representing them. Basically, there are 4 types of mapping cardinalities: 1-to-1, 1-to-many, many-to-1, and many-to-many. Now, based on how many entities from the first set are going to be participating in relation along with to the second set, that is defined by your mapping cardinality. For example, let us consider this scenario: in between student and school. In one school there will be many students, so many students studies in one school, so the relationship will be many to one. Now if we see the relation between your school and faculty, one school contains many faculties. Otherwise you can read from this side also, n faculties means many faculties works in one school. So this is going to become a many to one. If you are reading from this side, it is going to become a one to many. Now if you consider course and faculty, then one faculty can teaches many courses, because this is information is given here. Faculty can teach multiple courses to the students. So one faculty can teach multiple courses. So one will be here and n will be here. If you are reading from this side, so this will be many to one. And if you are reading from this side, faculty teaches courses, so one has to many. And last, now many students are taking many courses, means one student will have the multiple courses, and for one course there will be multiple students. So this relation will be many to many. Now this is your final ER diagram. In this year diagram, we haven't shown the attributes, but the attributes which we have identified in the step number one, these, right, you have to draw here also. Attributes are represented in the forms of ellipse. So for student, we have to draw the 5 attributes. For school, we have to draw 3 attributes which we have specified in the previous section, previous step. For faculty, we have to draw 4 attributes, and for course, we have to draw 3 attributes. And this is your final ER diagram. This ER diagram is very, very useful to get a relational schema. If we have a relational schema, we can implement the database. So to implement a database, we need a relational schema, and relational schema is generated with the help of ER diagram. That's why this ER modeling is very, very important concept in the database management system. I hope you have understood this tutorial. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.